Good morning.
How is it that we can rationalize, we can reason our disobedience when it suits us? Let's look at David for just a moment. A man with a heart after God. Half the Psalms written by him. A man who said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." A man who killed a bear, killed a lion, trusting God, taking care of sheep, so humble, so righteous, so holy, so good, with a heart after God. Yet, he commits adultery, rationalizes that. Then, when she's pregnant, he tries to figure out how he's going to get out of it. So he brings Uriah back, tries to get him drunk, to sleep with his wife, and that doesn't happen. So finally he resorts to murder. And he has him killed. And, you know, how in the world could he have fallen so far? You know, I've done a lot of thinking about that. How do religious leaders, I mean, high profile people, get into just blatant sin? I mean, and do it for years. How do they rationalize that in the position they're in? I have to go back to Moses. How could he hit that rock after being God's spokesman, a friend of God, somebody that talked to him face to face? How could that be? You know what I find? I find four things. Unresolved conflict, unmet emotional needs, unmet physical needs, and dreams on hold. I want you to think about it for just a minute. When something you want real bad and you're not getting it, it might be a physical need, emotional need, social need, financial need, or whatever, and you finally reach a point where you say, "I can't live this way any longer," or, "God's not going to do it, so I'm going to have to." And it's amazing to me how people will twist scripture. And they will say, "Well, the Bible, he knows that, but God allows this, and you know, it's all this, he'll make an exception for me." Really? Sin hurts you, and it breaks God's heart, because it does hurt you. I mean, if your child's going to put his hand in the hot stove, you'll stop him. But if he says, "No, Dad, I want to do it. Let me do it." He's like, "You're going to burn your hand. It's going to be scarred for life." "No, I want to do it. I need to do it." That would cause you great pain as a parent. What do you think God does? He is continuously loving us, continuously showing us these unmet needs that we resolve. What did Nathan the prophet say to David? "If you had told me, I would have given you such and such, what you needed. Why did you take it into your own hands?" You know what the answer to this is? "God, this is what I think I want, and this is what I'm asking you for. And I'm trusting you to give this to me. I'm not going to take it into my own hands. I'm not going to do it myself. I'm not going to dethrone you and enthrone myself and say, this is my fulfillment. I want this. I'm going to have it." I say, "No, you'll give me the grace not to have it until the time is right." This is so important. Oh, it's so huge in the life of a Christian. When we take matters into our own hands because we think God has forgotten us, put us on hold, or been some way unfair to us, as if that's a possibility, which it's not. But if when we start thinking those things, we're thinking the thoughts of the devil. And what did he say to Eve? "Has God really said to you?" He doesn't want you to be as smart as he is. He's holding out on you. God is never holding out on you. He's not. "Eye has not seen, neither has entered into the heart of man, the things that God's prepared for those that love him." You can't even imagine. God wants to do so much better for you than you can even dream for yourself. Don't short sell yourself and do something impulsively, because God will give you better. God bless you. Have a great day.